All right, welcome to bullwaves.org. This is a early weekend video. I'm going to go through the markets, obviously, from an Elliott Wave perspective. Stick around. I think you'll see something interesting. And check out bullwaves.org if you're interested in joining for the nightly Elliott Wave analysis that I do on the website for members only. Okay, let's get into what we're talking about here. Okay, I'm going to keep this video pretty short. You know, no major thesis has changed this week. We're just kind of rumbling along. We're getting a little bit corrective in many markets at the moment, but we're just kind of rumbling along the pattern, and it just takes time to unfold. In euro dollar, I'm looking at a second wave correction here. It looks like we've got the initial A wave down pretty much done. We're working on wave B, and then we'll go down into wave C. So it depends. I've got two versions, I suppose, on let's say the degree of which we could of the wave count. We could call this wave A in blue. Maybe I'll do that right now. Or we could be still working at 1 degree lower. You know, it's kind of up for discussion or up for debate right at the moment. But I think until we see the third wave down, I think that'll probably qualify which degree is best. I mean, if we fall and we break below the 50% retracement level, that'll probably indicate that that the wave two in green is actually the best way of looking at it. If we go to the hourly count here, I'm operating at 1 degree higher here, you can see. So we've got, either way, the count is the same. It's just you change the degree. Wave 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 down in wave A. Possible expand of flat correction wave B. We've got a kind of a sliding trade this week. It's just been kind of drifting lower without much impetus in it. Maybe we're working on an expanded flat wave B. Maybe it's a running flat. Okay, that's probably up for debate. If I change tonight, which, you know, I might do, I'm not entirely sure. We could read this action a little bit different. We could call this a fourth wave here, probably, you know, an expanded flat fourth wave, and then move this fifth wave down here, and that would become some sort of a trumpet pattern or a wedge pattern to complete wave five, and that would be wave A done down here, and then we'd go ABC off that. It doesn't change the overall thesis here, but it would probably fit the alternate count on the previous chart there, on the four-hour chart. For the moment, anyway, I'm still looking for some sort of retracement back towards 108 again before falling in a C wave, as shown. Okay, let's get into cable. This is the count in cable. We're still looking at the development of a C wave decline. So, you know, in line with what's happening with euro dollar, further downside to come here. I need another step lower. I'm looking for five waves down in wave five of C, I think, is on the short-term chart. We're on wave three of C at the moment. We've got five waves down in wave one. We've got three waves up in wave two. And then it looks like we've got a wave one, two, and possibly a third wave beginning this week, or maybe before tomorrow we'll cross over to a new low, probably break 119 again, and confirm wave three of C. For the moment, we do have a series of steps lower. Looks impulsive to the downside. Need confirmation of wave three of C, but I think there's probably further downside coming here. Once we break below 118 again, I think that'll pretty much confirm wave C is underway and confirm this count more or less. Okay, let's go to this is dollar yen. The count is still developing. I think at this moment in time, I'm probably leaning heavily in favor of this, in favor of the main count, while there are problems, but I think there's merit in the idea that we have now bottomed in wave four and we're looking much higher in wave five. If you go to the daily count here, I'll show you. That's the weekly count. You can see, anyway, we've bottomed in wave four here. We'd look for probably a push above 153 or something again to complete wave five. So there's, if this count is correct, there's a lot of upside ahead of us. If we go to the 4-hour count here, you can see that we have a three-wave pattern lower complete in wave four, and we're just bottoming off that, and we're kind of, let's say, we're not confirming anything yet, but we are moving in the direction of confirming a larger acceleration higher. You can see here, that's the interim low at wave four in blue, and we've got a possible, it's the internal count here is not perfect, I'll give you that, but a possible wave one rally, then a wave two higher low, and then a wave one three waves lower to a wave two, and then again a wave one three waves lower to wave two. You can't, the one thing I can't deny is the pretty much bang on perfect three wave declines to a higher low that have happened over the last few weeks. And then a possible third wave extension, which is most likely still underway. The question I've been posing myself, this week is wave four complete, or are we just kind of tracing out some sort of a flat correction here in wave four, and we're going to bottom again, probably test 133 again before heading higher. If that's correct, then you know we'll bottom in wave four pretty soon, and then spike higher in wave five again, and then after that it's going to be a series of corrections, spike to a new high, correction, spike to a new high, to complete five waves up. And that will probably take a while. I think it's going to take a while. If we start invalidating if we start breaking any of the previous wave one highs, so that comes in at 132.89, and then previously to that we have wave one in green, comes at 131.57. So if we start breaking those wave ones, then I'm going to probably switch. I'm going to rethink what we're doing here. But for the moment, it looks like we're pointing higher, tentatively higher over the next week anyway. Okay, here's the Dow. If you've been following the videos, you know that we were looking for a decline, and here comes the decline. Now, it's in line with what we were expecting on the nightly updates, but we haven't confirmed, wave three hasn't been confirmed yet. So the idea here would be for a break of that significant support there at one, what have we got, 32,500, let's say, at wave one here. We break that, I think, you know, all bets are off, and I think we're probably heading down in wave one of three, and which should be a pretty significant decline, I think. If we go to the hourly count here, you can see that's the wave two high. It looks like wave one of three is close to competing. The internal count here was not, you know, as good as I would have liked, but we continue to see corrections to the upside. You know, a new spike lower this morning or this afternoon now. Possibly in wave five of one. Now, I have been touting that wave B low here as the initial kind of, not trigger level, but, you know, signal level for this reversing market. And the market bounced off that level last night, rebounded in three waves, and now we're coming back to test that level again. So 32.930. At the previous wave B is looking like, it's providing enough support to hold the market right now. We'll see whether we slice through it or not. It would be nice to see a solid cut of that level, complete wave one. It would be even nicer to see a break of 32.560 again. And that would bring us back below the previous wave one low. At that point, I think the odds that the correction is complete in wave two and we are moving lower into wave three, you know, get much higher. So we're at a critical level, I think, in this wave count now. Obviously, you want to follow it, come and join the website each night. Okay, let's move on. Here is gold daily count. You can see we were looking for a turn. We've turned quite substantially now at this point. Not far enough though, I think. We haven't had enough to call a correction complete yet. And you'll see in the short term count why I'm saying that. But for the moment, I think we're moving towards a very bullish higher low. I don't think that's going to come until we see, you know, about 1750. About 1750, yeah. 3 waves down to about 1750. Yeah. That would be the level I'm looking for. The sort of action that I'm looking for wave two to be called complete. That brings us, you know, right back down into the range of the previous corrective low. Then, you know, at this point, I'm looking more towards pattern on the hourly count, and the pattern's not there yet. But if you're looking at fib levels, you know, between, you know, 18, call it 1780 and 1750 would be an ideal area for this correction to complete. So if we go to the hourly count here, and I'll show you what my pattern is at the moment. So I'm looking at 3 waves down in wave A, probably still an ongoing wave B. I have been looking for a bounce this week. But at this moment, we have just about pipped to a new low, below 1818 again. So that breaks the wave A low. But I think this could be an expanded flat wave B. And in that case, we should see a rebound in wave C, probably back towards, you know, 1860 or something like that. I'm being a little more conservative now. I was actually looking for, you know, something up towards, you know, 1880 or 1890 to complete wave B, but, you know, the market just doesn't seem to want to give it to us now. You know, I go from looking for the top to top out, and, you know, we climbed new highs to new highs, and now I'm looking for the bottom to bottom out, and we keep falling to new lows. So it's a process. Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself, but the process is ongoing. The pattern will complete, and once we start seeing a three-wave correction back towards about 1860, 1870 again, that'll complete 3 waves up, and then I'll be looking for wave C to turn lower again. So I still think there's a potential for a bounce here, probably back towards 1860, as I said, 1870, early next week, maybe by the end of tomorrow, by the end of Friday's trade, we'll probably have something in the bag for wave C, or to signal that wave C is underway. But, you know, step by step, we'll see what we get there next week. Crude oil, we'll go to 4-hour count in crude oil. Have been looking for this wave C to develop. And, you know, with the back burner alternate count, is still there. That's the kind of the ultra bearish alternate count. And that alternate count calls wave two complete. And this is wave one and two now developing and possibly moving lower into wave three. I don't think I'm kind of between two stools at the moment, let's say. The bearish side of me wants to say just, you know, screw it, wave two is complete. And we're moving lower into wave three, but we still seem to be building higher lows here. So I'm willing to allow this wave C another few days to either confirm or deny itself. And depending on what happens here, that will decide the larger count. Now you can see on the hourly count here, we could call this on the previous pattern that I was working with. Was calling wave two at the late January highs, and then ever since then we've been working lower in a series of one twos. You know, if that's the case, then if that alternate count is correct, then we will not challenge $80 again. We'll probably see some sort of a second wave lower high again, and then we'll accelerate lower. But I'm definitely stuck between two stools here, or two competing theories. And one has yet to become dominant, I think, at this point. But I'll follow them day by day, and we'll see which way the cookie crumbles, I suppose. For the moment, I'm going to allow the main count time to develop and see whether, you know, it will confirm or deny or invalidate over the next few days. So I think probably early next week is going to be crucial in this one as well. Once we break above $80 again, that will pretty much confirm this wave count. Okay, let's move on. Long term, I'm definitely looking lower in crude. If the stock market breaks, there's no way that crude is going to rally. That's just out of the question. Okay, let's go to the S&P. A similar pattern here. I may be kind of winging it a little bit here with the failed fifth wave idea. The Dow actually counts better off the high or the previous lower high. But for the moment, you know, this count seems to be working well. We have a lower high. We have a lower high wave two. We're working lower off that high right now. So wave three has yet to be confirmed, but we're definitely kind of we're definitely looking that way right now. If we go to the hourly count, and I'll show you, that's that lower high fifth wave. We had three waves down, wave four, and then a spike in five waves. There's clear five waves here. In wave five, just didn't manage to make it to a new high. That could be indicative also of just a complete, you know, momentum death in the rally. And we had so many overlaps within that previous rally that's, you know, a very viable thing to happen. It's not an unusual pattern for a failed fifth wave, but it, again, you know, there's no reason to suggest that, there's no reason to suggest that it should never happen either. I mean, it does happen. It's not infrequent either. We're counting lower at the moment anyway, so we're working lower in five waves. We seem to have a third wave complete at Wednesday's spike low. We worked higher in three waves. Maybe that's wave four done at today's or this morning's high. We've definitely fallen back off the early morning high. Haven't made it to a new low yet, but we've fallen back enough to suggest that maybe wave five of one is underway now. So the pattern is becoming clearer. We're working lower. We haven't completed five waves down yet, but it would be nice to see a break of 3870, let's say, to complete wave one, but we'll see whether we get there or not. For the moment, I'm working on the bearish count. We would be looking for a wave two lower high next week before accelerating lower in a wave three of one of three. So it'll be the first leg lower in a large third wave. So there's a lot on the line here, I think. And as usual, the overall trend, I think, let's go to the daily count here. The overall trend is to the downside. The market, while we haven't confirmed a third wave acceleration lower yet, we're most definitely working that way now. So I think it's time to be very cautious here, you know, especially with the way that things seem to be panning out right now. We start breaking to new lows and start breaking down on this market, then I think there's going to be very little to catch it before we start hitting, you know, we will break 3,000 pretty quickly, I think, in wave three. Once wave three does pick up speed. So, you know, I'm a voice of caution here, I think, this late Thursday evening. Let's move on. Go to silver, this is the 4-hour count on silver. Kind of toying with the idea that wave B in red here is underway. The pattern, again, it looks quite corrective off that wave A low, but we'll see how it goes. I'm kind of splitting hairs here. On the lower degree count, I'll show you the alternate here. That's on the hourly count, I'm working with the lower degree wave count, but the pattern itself fits a larger degree wave A. I've been developing the count just at this degree, so it might deserve to be stepped up 1 degree, as shown on the 4 count. So you can see here, if you follow me, I'm working on the red labels here. So the decline has been large enough, definitely, to suggest that maybe we should be on the larger degree count, but that's kind of semantics, really. In general, I'm looking for 3 waves down. I think we've completed wave A. We're probably working higher in wave B. I think there's probably more downside to come in wave C. We haven't had enough yet to break the back, I think, of the bullish action that happened previously in that wave one rally. So, you know, wave two is still underway. We're still tracing out 3 waves, 3 waves down overall. We will complete a B wave lower high pretty soon, you know, at which degree, you know, it's arguable, but I think we'll still turn down again impulsively into a C wave. And like most things, I think a downdraft in the stock market will take precious metals with it. And this time I'll be looking for a higher low in precious metals. And when that happens, or if that happens, if and when that happens, I'll be shouting from the rooftops to start accumulating. Okay, let's move on. I'm just going to skip to the end here. I don't have much to say about Bitcoin. You know, I think we're working on a fourth wave high here. I've stepped up the wave count, all right, but we're working a fourth wave high. I think it's a sucker high at the moment. I think we'll turn lower into a fifth wave pretty soon. Again, that theory of the downdraft will take a lot of markets with it. Let's get to the NASDAQ. Here's the 4-hour count of the NASDAQ. You see we had a pretty clear 3 waves run to a lower high, and now we're kind of working our way down again. Much like the S&P, you could probably read the recent action in a few different ways, but I'm choosing at this moment in time to allow the short-term action to choose or to clear up before like nailing my thesis to the church door, as it were. But we're definitely moving the right way. The higher degree wave count in wave 4 here, or sorry, the 4-hour count, does suggest that we should move down into a third wave now. I just don't think the action off the top here has been, you know, terribly clear yet. So, you know, I'll look for this to develop into 5 waves down, and once that happens, you know, then we'll start labeling that short-term chart. But it could be a series of steps, maybe a series of 1-2s to the downside. We'll see how it goes. That actually does it, I think, for the week. I know this is a Thursday evening video, but usually I leave these for Friday evening, but we'll have some family engagements tomorrow, so I wanted to get this video out anyway. I know if I don't do it now, I probably won't do it over the weekend. So as always, I leave you with the good news of Messiah. 2,000 years ago, the Lord Jesus, God incarnate in the flesh, our great God and Savior, came down, paid for our sins, so we don't have to. All we have to do is accept the work that he'd done. It was prophesied in the Old Testament, in the Hebrew Scriptures, it was prophesied. The Hebrews tend not to believe that, but, you know, that's also prophesied, that they wouldn't believe it. And he died for our sins, he rose again, left our sins in the grave, if you choose to believe. There was one problem in this whole scenario, and that is the scenario, or the reality of free will. So you have the free will, or we all have the free will, to accept or reject the work that God has done in Jesus Christ. So we can accept it. It's not religion, by the way. It has nothing to do with religion. As far as I'm concerned, Jesus completed religion. He lived the perfect life, the sinless life, and he was that lamb that went to the Temple Mount, that was slaughtered, and paid for our sin. So you can accept that, and I'll see you in heaven. You reject it, and I won't see you in heaven. I'm sorry. And apart from that, you know, if you, it's hard to do a sales pitch after that, but hey, go check out bullwinds.org, and we'll see you in the nightly updates. And check out Jesus Christ, because that's the eternal payment. Okay, God bless. See you next week if I'm still here. Bye-bye, YouTube land.